Welcome to Civil Services Achievers Point. We are discussing today the Assam Tribune of 10 September 2020. At Civil Services Achievers Point, we have various courses. To join these courses, you may call at the number given below. This Assam Tribune analysis is based on the new pattern of APSC. It is also useful for UPSC and other state level government examinations. These are the important newspaper articles we are discussing today and the important editorials. Students, from today we are beginning a new initiative, the daily current affairs MCQs, which are highly likely to come in the upcoming APSC examination. So today we are taking the current affairs from today's Assam Tribune newspaper. You can go through these MCQs and you will find the answer in our lecture, and kindly post the answers in the comment section. The answers to these MCQs will be posted tomorrow. So students, kindly check the video tomorrow for answers. So these are the important current affairs questions which are highly likely to come in the upcoming APSC exam 2020. So students, you pause this video in this slide and try to answer these questions and comment in the comment section below. So this is number 3, number 4 question, number 5, number 6, number 7 questions, very important question on Arunodoy, on government schemes. One question will definitely come. Then question 8, 9 and 10. So students, you can pause the video at the respective questions and answer them and post the answers in the comment section below, and we will discuss answers to some of these questions in our next slides. So students, let us begin with the news articles of today's newspaper. The first news article is that state government may have to rethink its COVID policy because, as per recent study, the plasma therapy did not help reduce the mortality as per the ICMR, that is the Indian Council of Medical Research. So this topic we will study under the General Studies on Assam paper, topic Polity and Governance. A multi-centric study funded by the Indian Council of Medical Research has found that use of convalescent plasma therapy, CPT, in COVID-19 infected patients does not help in reducing mortality or progression to severe conditions. So, as per the recent ICMR study, the plasma therapy does not help in reducing the mortality or even progression to severe condition. And this study is likely to prompt the state health department to revisit its plasma therapy policy, which it has been aggressively pursuing for more than a month now. In fact, Health Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma has been claiming that the therapy is giving good results. So this will challenge the state government's policy. The plasma therapy, now what is the plasma therapy? The plasma therapy involves taking antibodies from the blood of a person who has recovered from COVID-19 and transfusing those into an active coronavirus patient to help kickstart the immune system to fight the infection. So in Assam, plasma banks have been functional at the AMCH, Assam Medical College Hospital, Jorhat Medical College Hospital, the Tezpur Medical Hospital and the Silchar Medical Hospital, apart from the Guwahati Medical Hospital. So the state government has also launched a nationwide campaign seeking plasma, and donors may get preference in government jobs and schemes as per the announcement of the state finance minister. Now coming to our next important topic, France has described India as foremost Asian strategic partner. So this topic will come under general studies 2 paper topic international relations. So France has described India as its foremost Asian strategic partner and said the upcoming visit of its defense minister Florence Parly to the country is aimed at further strengthening the forward looking defense cooperation with New Delhi. So as we have already covered in our earlier class that the defense minister of France is visiting India to attend a ceremony in Ambala to induct the first batch of 5 Rafale jets into the Indian Air Force. Now the first batch of 5 Rafale jets arrived in India on July 29, nearly 4 years after India signed an intergovernmental agreement with France to procure 36 of the aircraft at a cost of ₹59,000 crore. So the French embassy has said that the talks will focus on maritime security ties in the Indo-Pacific, counter-terror operation and strengthening overall bilateral defense partnership. So these points are very important, that Indo-French talks will be on maritime security ties in the Indo-Pacific, counter-terror operation and strengthening overall bilateral defense partnership. Also, the talks will cover industrial and technological partnership in line with the Make in India program, operational defense cooperation, particularly maritime security in the Indo-Pacific, modalities of continuing the armed forces joint exercises in the context of the COVID-19 pandemic, counter-terrorism cooperation, as well as major regional and international strategic issues. Also, the talks will take forward the decision of French President Emmanuel Macron and Prime Minister Narendra Modi to deepen and expand the Indo-French partnership with strategic autonomy and the defense of a multipolar order as its cornerstones. Now coming to the next very important topic regarding our General Studies 2 paper, International Relations topic, India, France and Australia hold first trilateral dialogue and it will focus on the Indo-Pacific. So in a first of its kind, India, Australia and France held talks for the first time under a trilateral framework with focus on enhancing cooperation in the Indo-Pacific, a region that has been witnessing increasing Chinese military assertiveness. So in order to challenge the increasing Chinese activity in the Indo-Pacific region, 3 nations, India, Australia and France, have undertaken a trilateral framework with focus on enhancing cooperation. The focus of the dialogue was on enhancing cooperation in the Indo-Pacific region. The outcome-oriented meeting was held with the objective of building on the strong bilateral ties that the 3 countries share with each other and synergize their respective strengths to ensure a peaceful, secure, prosperous and rules-based Indo-Pacific region. So the meeting was held with the objective of building the strong bilateral ties that the 3 countries share and to ensure a peaceful, secure, prosperous and rules-based Indo-Pacific region. Further, the Ministry of External Affairs of India has said that the 3 nations agreed to hold a dialogue on an annual basis. It said the 3 sides discussed economic and geostrategic challenges and cooperation in the Indo-Pacific, particularly in the context of the COVID-19 pandemic and domestic responses. Further, the ministry said cooperation on maritime global commons and potential areas for practical partnership at the trilateral and regional level were also discussed, including through regional organizations such as ASEAN, Indian Ocean Rim Association and the Indian Ocean Commission. So this is a very important topic, students. please make a note of it. Now coming to our next topic, a very important topic from our Assam GS paper, Assamese film on the LGBTQI making waves. Now a film named Fireflies or Jonaki Porua. So a prelims based question may come in the upcoming exam. That film Fireflies Jonaki Porua is directed by Prakash Deka. So this point is very important. A question may come in the prelims examination. So the film Jonaki Porua or Fireflies is directed by Assamese director Prakash Jha, and it could be the first Assamese full-length feature film which directly deals with the LGBTQIA theme. Also, this, and only because of its unique and powerful storyline around a sensitive issue, the film has ignited a lot of discussion across all quarters on the general public. So coming to our next important topic, 13 million year old fossil ape discovered in Uttarakhand. So this topic will study under the General Studies 3 topic technology. So an international team of researchers has unearthed a 13 million year old fossil of a newly discovered ape species in Uttarakhand, which is the earliest known ancestor of the modern day gibbon. The fossil, a complete lower molar teeth, belongs to a previously unknown genus and species Capiramnogarensis, and represents the first new fossil ape species discovered at the famous fossil site at Ramnagar in nearly a century. So this point is very important. Students, please make a note of it. The researchers, including those from Arizona State University in the US and Punjab University in Chandigarh, were climbing a small hill in the area where a fossil primate jaw had been found a year before. Further, it is explained that there are other primate species known during that time, and no gibbon fossils have previously been found anywhere near Ramnagar. So the researchers have noted that the age of the fossil, around 13 million years old, is contemporary with well-known great ape fossils. This provides evidence that the migration of great apes, including orangutan ancestors and lesser apes from Africa to Asia, happened around the same time and through the same places. Further, it said that it found the biogeographic component to be really interesting. So today, gibbons and orangutans can both be found in Sumatra and Borneo in Southeast Asia, and the oldest fossil apes are from Africa. Knowing that gibbon and orangutan ancestors existed in the same spot together in northern India 13 million years ago and may have a similar migration history across Asia. Now coming to our next topic, Supreme Court has stayed the implementation of 2018 Maharashtra quota law. Now this topic we are studying under the General Studies 2 paper topic polity. The Supreme Court has stayed the implementation of 2018 Maharashtra law granting reservation on Marathas in education and jobs, but made it clear that the status of those who have availed the benefits will not be disturbed. So basically, the Apex Court has said that status of those who have already taken benefits of the 2018 law shall not be disturbed. The Socially and Educationally Backward Classes Act 2018 was enacted to grant reservation to people of Maratha community in Maharashtra in jobs and admissions. The Bombay High Court, while upholding the law in June last year, had held that 16% reservation was not justifiable and said that quota should not exceed 12% in employment and 13% in education admissions. On July 27, the Maharashtra government had assured the top court that it would not proceed with the recruitment process to fill up the vacancies on the basis of 12% Maratha reservation till September 15, except for departments such as public health and medical education research. So this is a very important topic. Now the next important topic is related to our general studies on Assam paper, culture and economic development. Now the topic is controversy over Gamusa GI Tag. So as we know that recently the Gamusa GI Tag was sought for, and controversy has raised over the issue of securing the geographical indication registration for the Assamese Gamusa. The controversy is not very helpful for the Assamese society as a whole. So the background is that the first application for GI registration of Assamese Gamusa was filed by the Institute of Handicraft Development, Dodhang, Boruabamungao, Kolaghat district in 2017. It was provided technical support by the Assam Agricultural University, Jorhat. The initial application filed by the Institute of Handicraft Development, IHD, sought the GI tag for Fulam Gamusa. The second application for the Gamusa was filed by the state's Handloom and Textiles Directorate with technical support from the Patent Information Center of the Assam Science and Technology and Environment Council on 2019, that is last year. It sought the GI registration tag for 7 types of Assamese Gamusa, and the Handloom and Textile Directorate raised 6 points while objecting to the IHD application, and it suggested the word Assam or Assamese should be considered for Gamusa's GI registration. The IHD stated that Gamusa should be accorded GI registration under class 25 meant for clothing. However, the Handloom Directorate said since Gamusa is also used as a bath towel and a towel to absorb water or sweat from hand or face, it should be covered under class 24, meant for towels. So there is a debate going on, and according to the Handloom Directorate, evidences of Gamusa's use in ancient Pragdispura or Kamrupa Kingdom, a part of which is now known as Assam, are found since the prehistoric days, even when it was the rule of Narakasura. This is learned specially from a painting in the Bhagavad Purana. It depicted a scene of the battle between Lord Krishna and Narakasura, where each of the warriors of Narakasura's army used Gamusa having the unique Assamese motif on his waist as a belt or tamali. Now coming to the next important news article, banks are the catalysts of economic revival, says finance minister. So this topic we are studying under the General Studies 3 paper, Economic Development. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman said banks are going to be the catalysts for economic revival, and also urged them to adopt digital technologies for efficiency and growth. Applauding the banks for their contribution towards the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, she, however, added that banking services have still not reached certain areas. She was speaking at the launch of the PSB Alliance Doorstep Banking Services, a customer outreach initiative by state-run lenders. The catalysts are going to play a very active role in making sure that every gap in the expectations of businesses which are struggling to get back to normalcy is adequately addressed. The minister said easy access and efficiency in providing banking services will help in revival of businesses which are restarting operations after the lockdown. Sitharaman urged banks to make special efforts to reach out to people through bank mitras so that no one feels excluded in the current digital revolution in the banking sector. Now we will discuss the important editorials of today's Assam Tribune newspaper. The first newspaper editorial is the renewed tension this topic we are studying under the general studies 2 paper topic international relations. So the background is that it is ironic that renewed tension between the line of actual control between India and China, between soldiers of the People's Liberation Army and Indian Army Jawans, have happened, and it has nullified the talks or good work between the Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Chinese President Xi Jinping. So focused as they are on lifting the living standards, the realization that neither China nor India can afford to have the non-productive and distracting conflicts had even led to a series of high-level summits, and which have been of no benefit. For instance, after the Doklam standoff, Chinese Defense Minister and his then Indian counterpart had met and devised the working mechanism for consultation and coordination on India-China border affairs was concluded, but the situation appears to have taken an even graver turn, with China alleging that Indian troops on September 7 this month violated a bilateral agreement and fired warning shots in the air during a confrontation on the border near the Pongsong So Lake. So with India undertake provocative activities, with India's external affairs minister terming the border situation in Eastern Ladakh as very serious, now the matter is of grave concern. Now coming to our next topic, GMC polls. This topic we are studying under the general studies on Assam polity. So it is the constitutional obligation of the state governments to ensure that the elections to the local bodies are held on time, so that the elected representatives get a chance to serve the people. But unfortunately, the government of Assam has violated the provisions of the Constitution of India by not holding the elections to the Guwahati Municipal Corporation, GMC, even after 2 years of expiry of the term of the last elected body. So the background is that the term of the last elected body of the GMC expired in July 2018 itself, and in more than 2 years, the state government has failed to take necessary steps for holding the polls. As per the provisions of the Constitution of India, the elections to the municipalities and panchayats should be held in every 5 years, and even if a body is dissolved by the government, elections should be held within 6 months. So this is a very important point. A prelims based question may come in the upcoming APSC exam. Students, please make a note of it. The government should have taken necessary measures to hold the elections immediately after expiry of the term of the last elected body. The State Election Commission can start the preparations to conduct the polls only after the government completes the process of delimitation of the wards and notify the reserved wards. After the expiry of the term of the previous elected body, the state government decided to increase the number of wards from 31 to 60, but the delimitation process is yet to be completed. So because of lack of an elected body, the GMC, which is already facing scarcity of funds, may face another major financial crisis, as it would be deprived of central funds as per the recommendations of the Finance Commission. Moreover, the citizens are also finding tough to ventilate their grievances because of lack of an elected body. Whenever an elected body functions, the citizens can always approach the ward councillors with their grievances. Now they are deprived of their opportunity. So under these circumstances, the government should immediately clear the hurdles for holding the polls. So with this, friends, we come to an end to today's Assam Tribune analysis. I hope this class was helpful. Thank you for watching the video. Thank you. Thank you very much.